to be famous, then you're going to do a lot to get there, like sign your name in blood in a contract with the devil. Like, you're going to end up on a one-way street, and it's going nowhere. Like, that's just the truth. I've seen so many people, like, forsake their moral code and their value systems just for a little bit of fame, and it's not worth it at the end of the day. It's really not.
dirty, dirty, beautiful, dirty, rich. For flash, and before I had it, I closed my eyes and imagined the good.
See, I met her at this party in Atlanta. Well, I met her at this party in Chicago. She came right up to me, giving me conversation. I said, "Do you got a man?" She said, "No, with no hesitation."
Well, it must be a music thing.
There, when Dre told me he would sell his soul to the devil for $1 million.
I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. This came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
I kind of sang about, you know, what was going on in my life at 15, and that's how I got introduced to the music industry. Is I swear I wanted to be like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
Why do you still do it? Why are you still out here?
Well, it goes back to the destiny thing. You know, I made a tough bargain with it, you know, a long time ago, and I'm holding up my hand.
What was your bargain?
To get where I am now.
Should I ask who you made the bargain with?
with the chief commander.
On this earth?
And in this earth, and then in the world we can't see.
We'll be right back.
says, how do you think that I became famous the way that I am? Well, I said, you must have had some good luck. Well, he says, there's no such thing as good luck. He says, there's either some power working for you somewhere, or you don't get ahead in this world. Not at my type of occupation.
I'm still alive.
So am I too. You can't kill a spirit even if you tried to. Soldier sold to me. Need I remind you? You remember that night you prayed to God you'd give anything to get a record deal with Dre signed.
It's like a boy in a bubble who never could adapt. I'm trapped. If I could go back, I never would have rapped. I sold my soul to the devil. I'll never get it back. I just want to leave this game with level.
One night I was in my home studio and it had to be like 8 to 10 people off in there. And we had beats and stuff playing in the background and everything. That's how we used to do it, you know what I'm saying? Everybody doing what they do, smoking, drinking and everything. And actually it came down to it that dudes actually started being used by demonic spirits. And these spirits started speaking through them, you know what I'm saying? Devils started speaking through them, talking to me, asking me, you know what I'm saying, if I was gonna sell my soul, telling me what I needed to do to take my career to the next level in darkness. I mean, dudes actually came up to me holding wads of money, saying, man, don't you want to make all this money? Now, like I said, you know what I'm saying, I wasn't church raised, you know what I'm saying, church every day and all that stuff, but I had went to church, and even though it was a traditional Baptist church, you know what I'm saying, I had heard about Jesus. I ain't really hear, you know what I'm saying, the truth and everything, but, you know what I'm saying, my questions that I had within myself began to be answered, and I knew that if those demonic spirits was real, if the devil was real, you know what I'm saying, and he was offering me a way, then I knew that God was real. So what I started to do, I grabbed a piece of paper that I had, my pad or whatever, and I just started to write, you know what I'm saying, started to repent, and I just read it out loud. And as I would read it out loud, I grabbed my paper and just started rapping, you know what I'm saying, and started apologizing to God. And as I would do that, somebody would leave my house. One of those spirits in those people would leave my house. I kept on doing it till all of them left. So I started coming clean with her, started telling her what was going on. She went and got the Bible. She opened it up to the 23rd Psalm. And all I saw was, the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You know what I'm saying? I just started to confess, you know what I'm saying? Jesus, asking Jesus to come into my heart and continually looking at that scripture, saying, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And I just said, Lord Jesus, just come into my heart, save my soul. You know, Jesus, just be my, just save me. I just need you to save my soul. I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to sell my soul. I didn't know I was away from you. I just need you to come into my heart, come into my life and be my Lord and be my Savior. You know, and of course, Jesus saved, you know, a cleansing work began in me. A cleansing work began in me. For the next 7 days, I continued actually to hear the demonic spirit still propositioning me to sell my soul, you know what I'm saying, in exchange for fortune and wealth or whatever in that music game, you know what I'm saying. It got so bad, I was so scared, you know what I'm saying, because that spirit of fear, you know, anything with the, man, that's his spirit, fear. You know, I was so scared, I made my mama even get in the bed and sleep with me. I like, don't leave me, don't leave me. I couldn't eat for the next 7 days, couldn't eat, couldn't do nothing. It was hard to sleep. The slightest thing woke me up. I look around, posters would be looking at me, blanking like this, you know what I'm saying? Jay-Z poster on the wall, just blanking, you know what I'm saying? Just looking at me. It was crazy, man. It was real, though. You know what I'm saying? True story. It had nothing to do with no drugs or nothing like that. It was just straight crossroads, intersection of the natural realm, you know what I'm saying? And the spiritual realm, you know what I'm saying? Butting heads, and I had to make my choice which way I was going to go, you know what I'm saying? So, on the last day, every time he would come in the house, troll would just swarm the house, you know what I'm saying? So I know I was under surveillance, even people after I make my little jugs or whatever.